Theodore Bundy was sentenced to die by a Miami jury for the murder of two Florida State University sorority sisters. Now the case is being retold to the Florida Supreme Court. Bundy's lawyer, Robert Harper, is appealing the conviction on several counts. First, that Bundy received inadequate counsel.
And how many lawyers would he need in order to be effectively represented?
One effective one, Your Honor.
He represented himself.
The state's attorney countered that, arguing that Bundy hired and fired an army of lawyers at will. Justices then heard more claims by the defense that hypnotism of Nita Neary, a witness who identified Bundy, was improper, and that Dr. Richard Suveron of Coral Gables used bite mark evidence to sensationalize the trial.
Here we've got five casts that different experts say are consistent with the bite mark, yet at the same time we have one doctor who is out to get famous on this case saying that beyond a reasonable doubt or with beyond a reasonable dental certainty, this defendant made those bite marks at or near the time of death.
This is the sorority house where the murders were committed and where the evidence was gathered. During the appeal, Justice James Atkins put the burden of proof on the state, asking, and I quote, "Other than bite marks and a hypnotized eyewitness, what proof do you have that Bundy was actually here?"
We brought you circumstantial evidence. We proved that Mr. Bundy was in that close proximity. Frankly, when you get right down to it, circumstantial evidence is if it looks like a horse and it eats like a horse and it rides like a horse, it's probably a horse.
Bundy's appeal is far from over. At a later date, his lawyers will argue that the death penalty was not a proper punishment. Jerry Cohen, Channel 4 News, Tallahassee.